Hello, welcome to Charlie's Lessons. And in this video, we're going to be comparing Kahoot and Quizizz. And we're going to be comparing only the basic accounts, so the free accounts that you can use in 2021. And so by the end of this video, you're going to have all the information you need to choose the right tool for you and your classroom.
So these are the things we're going to look at when we're comparing the two. So let's get started with the first one, how we get set up on Kahoot and Quizizz. So starting with Kahoot, first we're going to go to sign up, which is followed by these options. So I'm going to go for teacher. Then I would also go to school, but if you're working in a university or in a language school like myself, then you might go to higher education. Let's go to school. And then you're faced with the typical email sign up. I usually do everything through Google, but it's up to you. Here we have to choose a price plan. Let's go with the free one. Then it just asks us for information about you and your school. Now moving on to Quizizz, we're going to go to sign up. And we can also use our Google account too. As a Kahoot, we're going to choose a school. And let's say we're a teacher again. So as we can see, both are really easy to get set up with. Now moving on, let's make a quiz in both Kahoot and Quizizz. So let's get started by making a quiz on Kahoot first. So we're going to click on Create. And we're going to click on Create a New Kahoot. We're not going to use the templates for now. So here we have our first question. Let's think of an example. We're going to need to tell Kahoot which one is the correct answer. So we're going to click here. And this is basically the first question is done now. Now we can add an image or a YouTube link. And to the left here, we can choose how much time we want to give our students to answer this in class. You can see here we've got a number of different options, the most being 240 seconds and the least being 20. I usually like to set this to around 30 or 60, as when students are connecting, they need a little bit more time to see the question and so on. Now, we don't only have to do multiple choice. If we click on the left-hand side, add a question, we can also choose a true or false. This is the only other option we've got available to us on a basic Kahoot account. As you can see, the others are locked off as premium, as you can see by the symbols. So this is a good time to move over to Quizizz and just compare how Quizizz's basic account, what options they've got for you. So you can see when you're making a question in Quizizz, you've got all these different options, which are, you know, you've got six different options here. So this is definitely a plus for Quizizz. Just staying with Quizizz and making a question in Quizizz is pretty similar to Kahoot, really. You can see the multiple choice question here. The timings as well are quite similar to Kahoot. There is a 15-minute option there, though, which is not available in Kahoot. Just focusing on some things that Quizizz has that Kahoot doesn't and vice versa. With Quizizz, we can use this slide option here. Which allows us to import a PowerPoint presentation and use the slides within the quiz itself. So you can see here in the bottom left-hand corner, we can either add slides using the Quizizz slide function here, or we can import them from your computer. If we go back to Kahoot, you can see here that the import slides button is again reserved for premium account users only. So that's one thing that Quizizz has over Kahoot. But if we stay with the Kahoot just quickly, when we want to put a YouTube video into Kahoot, it does allow us to do that. And all we need to do is just simply input the link here and set a time of when you want the students to watch the video. And you can set a question based on the video they're watching. While with Quizizz, when we make a multiple choice question, for example, and we do want to include a video, then we are greeted with this message, which is saying that we're only allowed to use that with premium accounts. So going back to Kahoot, this is something that definitely Kahoot has over Quizizz in this respect. Let's look at what Kahoot can give us in terms of ready-made questions for our quiz that we're making. So if we click on the left-hand side, question bank, it asks me to type in a question I'd like to search for. So we've got here, we have a list of questions that we can add to our quiz. And as you can see here, it's not only searched for exactly the phrase I typed in, but it's also given me some alternatives as well. So I'm going to add all of these to my quiz.
There's the question I asked. And you can see here down the left-hand side, I've already got now 4 questions in total. And even some of these questions, for example, question number 4 already has an image attached to it, which is nice. And the question's ready to go. Now moving on to quizzes, we're going to use the teleport function. And you can see I've already got a question I've loaded up. And what I like about this is that it not only gives me the questions on the right-hand side, but it also gives me the quizzes in which these questions are contained. So I've got a list of quizzes on the left-hand side, and I can actually explore all the different questions that were contained in that quiz. And there's a chance that I'm going to be finding a lot of useful questions here for my quiz. So this one, and this one, and this one here. And now you can see that my quiz is now 3 questions long. And again, there's images attached. The correct answer has already been marked. And so this quiz is ready to go. I feel like the quizzes feature is a lot more time effective, and I was able to do this a lot quicker. And also just the fact that I can look at other quizzes and the rest of the questions that are contained in each quiz. Whereas with Kahoot, when I search for the question in the question bank, I'm given the questions individually, and if I want to look at the quiz itself where the question is contained, I click on the link here, but then that sends me to another page where I'm actually now away from my quiz and I have to then go back. So I just find the quizzes one a bit easier to use.
Now, if you're a teacher like me, then you probably don't have time to be making quizzes from scratch, even with the question banks that the Kahoot and Quizizz platforms offer us. So really, we're interested in the ready-made quizzes that we can just copy and use when you need them for your class.
So starting with Kahoot, if we click on the Discover button at the top, then we can see this range of quizzes that we've got available to us that we can use. And if you're going to teach something specifically that you already know, so let's say tomorrow I'm going to teach the adverbs of frequency, and I'll search for that. You can see there's a lot of content here. Let's go with this one from the Kids Like the Simpsons. I can see that there's 14 questions. If I click up here, I can see the answers, and yeah, that looks good. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to click on these little 3 buttons. I'm going to click duplicate. And now this quiz is going to pop up in my Kahoot, and I can edit it or I can just directly play it with my students. And moving on to quizzes, we're going to search for the same things we searched for on Kahoot. So we're going to search for adverbs of frequency. And what I like about this is that we can hover over each quiz and we can see down on the right hand side what kind of questions are in the quiz again, and we don't have to click on it. One important thing to note, don't use the ones, if you're working on a basic account, try not to click on the ones that have the super attached to it, because that means it's a premium quiz and it won't let you play it with your students if you have a basic account. So we can see all of these. So if you want to save one of those to your library, then we just click on save and we can add it to a folder. And so again, if we go to my library, we can see here that we've already added some tests beforehand and some quizzes here. And these quizzes are now ready to go with your class. Now that we've made quizzes on both of these platforms, let's see what it's like playing them in class. So to play with these quizzes with your students in class, it's really easy to get started. You just go to your Kahoot, in this case, and we're gonna click on play. Now, we've always got 2 options here. We can either do the quiz there and then with your students, or we can assign it for later on for the students to do at home. I think we're going to just look at what it's like when we play it live with the students. So I'm going to click on teach. Now we get these 2 options, and for me there's not much difference between the classic and team mode. So we would usually just go for classic. If the students are making teams, they can do that with the player versus player. It's just a case of changing the name of the team to reflect the group. There are some options here. We can have change the music that we want to listen to during the quiz. We can randomize the questions, and there's a lot more options here. Click on classic. This is what the students see. What we're waiting for now is the game pin, which has just appeared at the top. We wait for the players to join either via their mobiles, tablets, or laptops. Their names will begin to pop up at the bottom here, and then you're ready to go and you just click start. Now with quizzes, we're just going to click on the quiz that we have ready to go. And we get two options, like in Kahoot, to play it with our students there and then, or set it as homework. Let's choose the option to play it there and then. We're going to choose the instructor paste version. We're just going to go to continue. And here we can see that we've got the code at the top, and the students enter this website and they enter their name, and then we can get started by clicking start.
Now, not long ago, Kahoot was really the only one that offered the students this live in-class experience, but Quizizz, with the live instructor function, has now solved one of its biggest problems as a platform.
Once you've played these quizzes with your students, you get access to reports, and these reports can help you build the next quiz or your next lesson. So I'm going to start with quizzes. I'm just going to show you the reports I've got for one of the tests I did with my class. And as you can see, there's a lot of information here that you can use to build your next class or next quiz. You can see right off the bat, we can see who did the best, who did the worst. We can see the overall accuracy of the quiz. We can look at individual questions if we want to focus on that. And there's an overview as well. So we can look at all the questions and pick out which questions were the most troublesome for our students. So with the Kahoot reports here, let's look at one example. We've got a summary, we've got players, we've got questions, so we can look at the players individually or the questions individually. But one of the great things about the Kahoot report is this option here. We can create a new Kahoot with only the difficult questions. And we can also look at students who need help in the future. These really help you in building or planning your next quiz or your next lesson. Now that we've seen what reports can give us as teachers, let's look at the final point, which is how we connect these two platforms with Google Classroom. Now, to set these up with Google Classrooms, we're going to create links to our quizzes so the students can do it in their own time at home. So to do that, we're going to click on play for one of our quizzes. And now instead of going to teach, we're going to go to assign. So let's create a new one. Again, we can change the date. We can change the time, and we've got a couple of options on the basic account of randomizing the order of the answers and a question timer. So let's go to create. So you can see there's a lot of options here, but we're gonna use Google Classroom, and this will take you to all the Google Classrooms that are associated with your account. Over to quizzes, it's pretty similar. We choose a quiz. Again, we're not going to go on the left, we're going to go on the right. We're going to go to assign as homework. Again, we get an option to choose when we would like the students to do this. So we're going to click on the Google Classroom link here. And there, as you can see, if you have classes open, you can just select the classes which we'd like to share the quiz with. Now we've seen how we can connect the two platforms to Google Classroom.
So there you have it. We've compared a lot about these two platforms, Kahoot and Quizizz. And I think looking ahead into 2021, I would probably choose Quizizz as my main platform for assessing my students, while I would still use Kahoot because you can always check both libraries for both platforms if you're looking for exactly what you need. But I'd say that if you're going to choose one, I'd probably go with Quizizz for now.